there is a need to reduce this overemphasis on academic results. We have made several steps in this direction over the last few years. For example, in 2012, we stopped naming the top PSLE scorers. Today, we celebrate students' performance in all domains across both academic and non-academic areas. But I think we can do more to change mindsets and culture. PM had announced in 2013 that we would review the PSLE scoring system. I would like to share an update on this today. The main issue to address is the way we currently score the PSLE is too precise and differentiates our students more finely than necessary. A student may score 1 point more than his friend at PSLE, but educationally, that 1 point does not mean that he is better prepared for secondary school than his friend. It also does not mean that he is very much smarter or will grow up to be more capable or lead a more successful or fulfilling life. We should, therefore, in time, move away from such fine distinctions, which are not meaningful, especially at that young age. The way that the T-score is calculated may also have created unhealthy competition among our young children, because it is calculated based on how students do relative to one another. Students may feel the pressure to do better than their peers rather than help each other out to learn. This runs counter to the values we want to inculcate in our children. We can find a better balance between encouraging our students to study hard and get good results and making them overly competitive and anxious about outdoing one another. Our overarching objective in the primary school years is to build strong foundations for learning in our children. After studying the issues carefully, we propose to make a few changes to the PSLE scoring system. First, we will replace the PSLE T-score with wider scoring bands, and the new system will be similar to the O and A levels. Some broad level of differentiation is still needed to guide students to academic programs that best suit their interests and strengths. But the scoring will be blunted to a large extent. Also similar to the O and A levels, we will move towards a scoring system that is more reflective of a student's learning and level of mastery. Once a student shows a level of understanding and ability that meets the professionally set standard, he will receive the grade regardless of how his friends may perform. This is more educationally meaningful than assessing a student's performance relative to his peers. We know that there will be many questions about how these changes will impact also secondary school posting. We intend to make some adjustments to the secondary one posting system as well. It will still be a fair and transparent system based on academic merit. With the move to broader PSLE scoring bands, students will be able to choose a school that is a good fit for them from a wider range of schools of a similar academic profile. In doing so, students can consider factors such as the school's distinctive programs, CCAs, and partnerships with the community and industry, and better match these factors with their interests. These planned changes are significant, so MOE will not rush the implementation. The current PSLE system is well established, and we must be fully ready before moving to the new system. So we will take the next few years to work through these changes carefully. We have already begun our journey of evolving our school landscape. We want to give all schools time to develop their distinctive strengths and niche programs towards the vision of every school a good school. This remains important. Meanwhile, we will need to develop and test the new PSLE scoring and posting systems thoroughly. Most importantly, we want to give enough time and support for parents and students to understand and adjust so that they are ready when the new system takes effect. So we are planning for the new PSLE scoring system to be put in place from 2021. This will start with the primary 6 cohort of 2021, who are in primary 1 this year. Details about the changes to PSLE scoring will be released in the next 2 to 3 months. Over the next few months, MOE will be working closely with our school leaders and educators on the proposed changes. We will subsequently also engage parents and members of the public on these changes and provide an update at the COS supply debate, COS debate of 2017.